All right, here's the question. How do you reduce your hard bounce rates? And this is important, first of all. Why is it important? Because when you send out email campaigns, HubSpot marketing email campaigns,
yes,
HubSpot looks at your bounce rates and your spam rates and unsubscribe rates. And if they're too high, it can actually potentially get your account suspended.
Hmm.
So based on percentage rates, okay? So then the question is, well, how do you reduce your hard bounce rate? So I was chatting with Adam at FGM. Thanks for this one, Adam Downer, a great friend of the show. And, oh, and by the way, we caught up with him on Monday night. It was great for burgers.
I know, it's fantastic.
Anyway, I digress. But he was telling me, he's like, here's the crazy thing. Do you know how to get your bounce rates down? You just send more emails. I'm like, oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's a percentage-based game,
it's a percentage,
right,
thing. And so here's the thing with bounce rates. Let's say, and I'll just work through some quick numbers. Let's say 20%, or let's say 24% churn rate is the average for accounts. So that you've, let's say you've got 100 contacts, 24% churn rate. So that's about 24 contacts over 12 months. That's 2 per month. Okay, so if you're sending out to those 100 and 2 of them are bouncing, if you're sending every month, 2% bounce rate, acceptable. Let's say you send out quarterly, to those same 100 people, well, 3 months later, oh, there's probably 6 of them are gone. Oh, wow, that's 6% bounce rate. Your account's probably been flagged. So you see the numbers there. So it's crazy. What it's actually meaning is that you should be sending more emails, even if they're not that relevant, just
more
so
often,
that you keep these bounce rates, these percentages down. So you're kind of probably going to reduce quality, but you've reduced your chance of your account having issues. So I think that's crazy. That's why we've called it the bogus tip of the week, but it actually is, it's just a numbers game. And so that's how you keep going. What's the summary? Send more emails and you've got less chance of your account getting flagged.
Here's so, Craig,
yeah,
do you think it's send more emails more often? So, if like frequent, yes, it's frequency.
Frequency, yeah.
But not even like, let's call it segmentation. It's actually just have a larger number that you're sending it to and
yeah,
do it more
well,
often.
If you just do the numbers, and let's say a typical churn rate is 20 to 30% per year.
Yeah.
So, based on those numbers, if you're not sending at least monthly to your most of your database, you're really setting yourself up potentially for hitting bounce rate limits. And look, HubSpot's reasonable. It's not like they're ruthless, but you could potentially get, we've temporarily suspended your account because of such and such because you just didn't send many emails last year. Oh, we didn't really have anything relevant to say. And there's lots of corporates that are like this.
Hmm.
And so I think this is the problem. And I don't know what the solution is, but I think, it's, well, from the HubSpot side, I see why they do it for email deliverability, but it's a silly solution to the problem. So, yeah, bogus tip, but it actually works.
I actually listened to some training from somebody. I think they're in the US. Their agency, all they do is focus on email deliverability and improving that for people. So, yeah, how do they warm up the domain? They're talking about warming up the domain, possibly even having multiple domains that emails are getting sent from. So it was kind of interesting in that perspective to think that there is, that this is happening and then there are people purely focused on it. So I think something to be aware of, and thank you for highlighting it.
Yeah, and by the way, it gets worse because as Adam was pointing out to me, often corporates, they will delete accounts on a semi-regular schedule.
Yep.
Right, so they might do it quarterly. So what that means is initially someone leaves a company and the first thing that they do is, well, their inbox kind of probably diverts to their manager in the interim until they pile up. And then eventually the IT manager says, oh, we've got about, you know, all these ones accumulated. So this quarter we'll delete them. So bang, suddenly you get this spike in bounced emails. And so it's important that if you're over your database, you don't like, well, suddenly all those accounts. So if you've been doing it monthly, oh, this one had culled a bunch then and then next month forgot them so they don't accumulate. You've got to think about this.
Yeah.
And I know I've kind of labored the point here, but this has kind of been an eye-opener for me. Yeah.